guys, it's Cindy Lumpkin here. I am a special education teacher who happened to have started her own school. I make videos about all things special education, as well as videos teaching parents and teachers how to start their own school. Well, today we are going to be talking about curriculum, and more specifically, we're going to discuss a multisensory math curriculum that can be used for students who have dyscalculia or other math challenges. Okay guys, so let's jump right in. I want to do an introduction and unboxing of the math curriculum, Math UC, which is a multisensory math curriculum that can be used for students who have dyscalculia or other math challenges. Math UC is a complete K-12 math curriculum that uses manipulatives to really help your child to understand and make math more concrete so that your child can better understand some of the more abstract parts of math, which makes learning math for those who have dyscalculia a bit complicated. And so anything that's multisensory tends to do very well with students who have learning disabilities like dyscalculia, like dyslexia. And for that, I believe that this curriculum will do very well for students who have math problems. Now, many of you have asked me to recommend a math curriculum for your child or student who have difficulties with math. And until now, I have not really been able to really find a reasonably priced one that I also think would actually do the trick. But once I came across this one, I said, I have to do this video to share it with you because it is promising. Now, have I completely tried it out on some of my students? No, because I really just kind of came across of it, and I'm previewing it now, and I'm also using it with my K-4 child, and so far so good. So I'm loving it, but it sold me with its multisensory approach. So I'm gonna go ahead on and show you what you get. This is kind of the gold in this curriculum. This is what makes the curriculum multisensory. This is what they call an integer block kit, okay? So in it, you basically have these blocks that represent numbers 1 through 10. And so as you can see, here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and it continues to go on like that. So once you purchase one complete set, as your child continue to progress through the levels, you do not have to repurchase this. This is designed to go from K all the way up until algebra, and then there are two other resources eventually once you start doing fractions that you can buy as an add-on, as well as algebra. But for right now, especially if you're working with students in elementary, this and on up to middle school, this will be all you need for each level. And then all you will have to do is buy the teacher's manual as well as the student book. So this is what the teacher's manual look like right here. And then you have the student workbook. Something else that I really, really love about this program is the digital math pack that you also get. And obviously it's on CD, but you can access it through online. And because I don't use CDs too much anymore, I've chosen to use the online version, which I will show you a little bit more later. All right, so let me tell you a little bit more about Math UC. So it's a complete math curriculum. So they start out from primer and go all the way up to calculus. And they use a mastery-based approach, which means they start out from the ground and build on top of the different lessons versus jumping all over the place, which once again, when we're talking about learners who learn differently, who have things like dyslexia and dyscalculia, you really want curriculum that is designed to teach the student explicitly and sequentially. We don't want to jump all over the place like sometimes standards do, but it's built upon mastery. That way the child learns a little bit, you add a little bit more, and all the while it's going back reviewing some of the lessons that have been previously taught, so that as the child continues to build on their mastery, you can be assured that they're not losing it, that it is foundational. So once again, I love that about this program, because that's what my school, that's what, as a teacher, I pride myself on not being as ambiguous, but starting out small and then building on top of that. And let me add, this is the primer level. I also have the geometry level, which I am currently using with some of my students. So I definitely will make another video to kind of let you know how it is going with that. But as you can see, they have lessons from 1 to 30 in this primer set. Let me make this point again. This curriculum was really designed with the homeschooling parent in mind. Now, what I tell a lot of the teachers who kind of ask me advice about starting their own program is to not count out the different programs or curriculums that are designed for homeschool, because one, they are much more cost effective. Two, I really believe a lot more of them are designed the way that the big box schools curriculum should be designed, and they're not. So with that being said, there is a teacher who actually goes through and teaches each lesson. And the way that you can use that as a parent is you can go and view the lesson yourself. You can actually sit down and view the lesson with your child. The way we use it in our school is twofold. We have our students to look at it, because we're always trying to get them to be as independent as possible. So we allow them to look at it to see what they can glean. Then our math teacher will come back and teach that concept to them. And for us, the whole purpose of what we want our students to do is to be able eventually to teach that concept back to us. And you can almost guarantee that the students have almost, if not have, mastered that skill once they're able to teach it to you. Okay, so with that being said, let's go ahead on and show you what the digital pack looks like online. So once you sign into your account, on the left-hand side, you will go down to digital toolbox. So once you click it, it will bring you to a screen where it actually has all the products that you are entitled to see. So right now I have Math UC. I actually have the Geometry 2, but I have not accessed it yet. So I have to use my code. But once I do, then it will go under here and it'll allow me to see it. So here's the gentleman that I told you would teach each level. And if we go over here, then you will click on whatever the product is that you purchased, right? So we only have Math UC Primer. So we would click Primer here. And as you can see, it will have all of the lessons. So he does an introduction here, and then we go into lesson 1, 2, and so forth. All right, so if we scroll down even more, let's see where it says resources, let's click on it. So you have some online drills, you have some additional facts worksheets, subtraction worksheets. I love this. I'm gonna show you this because you actually have the checklist. I am not big on like grades and report cards. I mean, nothing against report cards, because we have to know how, or students have to have a way to know how they are doing, right? Or being evaluated. So it's not about the report card. I'm just not a huge fan of grades, because when you look at grades, it's like you can have these ultimate winners or losers, right? And I really feel like an A that means you know everything, and an F that means you didn't learn anything. What I love about this, if I could do anything like in the education world, I would have report cards to almost stay like they do in kindergarten, and I guess sometimes first grade, where it's more skill-based. So you have an assessment sheet here, where every objective that is taught, you can go and check whether or not the child has actually met that objective. And to me, that is more telling versus, oh, you have a random A. So if I taught, I guess, what, 15 of these lessons in one semester, I want a parent to be able to know they know this, this, and that, versus just saying, oh, they got an A, right? That A is so like ambiguous, But once you give them the objective, it really makes it more specific and you can really hone in if they didn't learn anything. Because once again, it just because you got an A doesn't mean you learned everything, right? It just means what you did. No, you did extremely well, but you could have done not so well on some other things. And then when you get into averages, it covers that up. So anyway, I absolutely love this sheet because I can really track where or what my students are doing. And then you have the digital manipulatives. Once again, I love this as well. If you want to integrate using the technology and using these manipulatives, you can do that as well with this. But once again, nothing beats actually putting your hands on it, moving it, pushing it, and just that feel experience. I do like the idea that they have it digitally as well, because if you do have like your pad or your computer, you can use it too. But I will say, do not forsake the use of the physical manipulatives. Once again, I am really in love with this program. I think it has a lot of potential. I definitely will keep you guys posted as I work with my own daughter. So far, so good. I'm seeing a lot of good things. It is definitely something that I am considering adopting for Triumph School. I hope this has been helpful. I will make sure I put links below. You guys have a great day.